Hey, how's it, guys? My year one got short play. We're recording, I think. I'm pretty sure we are. This is Crue Ball for the Sega Mega Drive. Those of you who are familiar with 80s American glam rock will be familiar with the soundtrack to this game. It was basically provided by Motley Crue. I say that these are kind of MIDI versions of the songs, that one being Dr. Feelgood. I was a bit of a rocker in the 80s, but I was a bit of a kid as well. But see, some of the music in this is pretty close to the originals. sorry, I'm just laughing at the concept of the game. This doesn't always contain, it's not always true to the original songs, which annoyed me immensely about this game, because it was going to be a Motley Crue game, but Motley Crue soundtrack, they needed to make it the Motley Crue soundtrack. And what they did was actually used a few songs, Dr. Feelgood. That second song there sounded a bit like Shout of the Devil, but it wasn't quite. And maybe it was off an album that I wasn't familiar with, but I was pretty much familiar with most of, if not all, of the Motley Crue albums as a kid. I'm probably going to be annoyed by the soundtrack in this game. That's a nice bit of pixel art there. Right, let's just play the game. Oh, that's a pause button. Right. A button does that, and we are... Oh! Sorry, that one. Oh, the dog could hear me then. Alright, this is the... Right, C does that. Yeah, let's establish the controls before we die. That's a good idea. I was never really into these pinball games either. They weren't exactly hyper-realistic. I think the thing is, the first computer-generated computer game, pinball game I played was Pinball Dreams on the Amiga. Now, that was beautiful. And it felt very pinball-y, and all the sounds were really authentic, real kind of sampled sounds. That's going to be some cliche like headbanger, isn't it? Which is just nonsense. Doesn't really. Actually, I thought this game didn't really do the music of the band just this time. That annoyed me. And I wasn't that into pinball games because Pinball Dreams was awesome. And I don't think the Mega Drive could really pull off the sort of sounds that we needed to make them immersive. Alright, the Amiga also, Pinball Dreams also. It just had, see, this looks like pixelated cartoon graphics. It is headbanger. Really. Yeah. See, I went to the Crazy Awesome Saturday night, and people in the mosh pit were not moshing to Motley Crue. God. A lot of tired cliches attached to this game. Pinball Dreams, for example, and Fantasies and Illusions. I think I played them all at some point earlier. But they all have this authenticity, they all have this immersion, so that was what made a good pinball game that feels like a computer representation of a pinball game. It doesn't really have anything. Because, you know, anyone can do that, but you've got ball gravity, you've got a nice, like, that's a nice bit of graphics on the ball. You've got that kind of red blue shine thing going on. It's pretty, it's competently drawn, you know. Yeah. What does this pinball game offer that likes a Pinball Dreams doesn't? Alright, you can argue it offers progression, which is kind of cool, and alright, I'll give it that. But I think the likes of Dragon's Fury does it so much better with the characterization. You can't really argue with that. No, the centipede thing is a character. And those little skull things that were wandering about were pretty weak as characters. Oh man, that's what I thought I'd do. I'm not making progress either, I know I'm not really showing any skill. Ooh, really. But I get the feeling early on in the game, it should give you a bit more of a sense of progression. Dragon's Fury, was it? It did that sort of thing pretty well. It also, I think the graphics were also stylized for Dragon's Fury. What is it called? There's two of them. Dragon something. Yeah, the graphics were stylized in such a way that you could believe it wasn't a pinball game, it was kind of a medieval adventure as well. This one is just trying to be a pinball game, but with some relatively weak characterization in it. And some relatively weak progressive elements that are done, as I say, better by Dragon's World and that other Dragon's Something game. I find myself too often just flailing the buttons and not really liking much about this game. Except the music, let's just listen. No, I don't recognise it now. I do know, I'm not into it. See, my favourite Motley Crue phase was the 1995 John Corabi phase where they went a bit grunge. Everything went slow and the rhythms was all about the drums, the massive Tommy Lee, you know. And there's a massive ego. But they were all about the drums and how awesome the fat the rhythms and the bass and the kind of beat of the music was. If you haven't heard it, check it out if you're into, you know, rock and metal. It's worth checking out. Those albums of John Corabi were awesome. I can't remember it. It was like an American release on the first one, but I skipped all of it as you did. And my mate James, who was the drummer in my band actually from me at the time, got hold of that and got me a copy on tape, and since I think I got it on CD, and, you know, God knows, it's probably in the garage or something, I've got all my CDs. But, and the album Motley Crue, the eponymously titled album, which is kind of funny because they went back to the old side, so it doesn't really sum it up at all. It sums up the phase. Oh yeah, go on, that headbanger thing. That's just taking the aggression out on that little V-shaped board thing there. Yeah, go on, and the other one. God, that was the first bit of skill I was about to show. Yes! Okay, progress. God, progress. Oh, I don't know how to progress from that point. But I'm familiar with all the music that they did, I think, pretty much. What we've got is kind of weak MIDI renditions, decent MIDI renditions of some of their songs, about two or three of them, I think, or three or four of them in that game, but other than that, the rest of the music is pretty weak, cliched rock beats and bass lines, and it feels like it's made by someone who doesn't really appreciate their music and isn't into that, which is fair enough. I'm not really these days, especially the old stuff, I didn't really like it. As I say, that mid-90s era was awesome. Definitely checking. Just listening to the music. Yeah, it doesn't sound like Motley Crue to me, that any of Motley Crue. It's got the feel good rendition at the beginning, it's pretty decent because it's a pretty recognisable song, you know. But I don't know what it's playing now. It might be a Motley Crue song. It doesn't feel like one to me, or sound like one. Yeah, not really into that. Bit of a shame because I was a kid who liked Motley Crue. Crue Ball, Sega, Mega Drive. Thanks for watching.